we opened the show with a clip from Nancy Pelosi outraged that new congresswoman, freshman congresswoman, I guess you would say, Marjorie Taylor Greene from the, I think it's the 14th congressional district in Georgia. She was probably the most celebrated, as it were, QAnon believer elected to Congress in this last go-round.
Yes, there were more than one.
But she was the most prominent. And
but Ronna McDaniel, the head of the RNC, says that QAnon is just fringe, completely out there, and yet at least two members of Congress who
at least
believe it.
Yes. I mean, and gosh knows how many people fed into this. I mean, let's face it, the QAnon fiction, if you will, conspiracy theories, drove much of the notion that the election was stolen. And we know from polling that up to 75% of Republicans believe in one form or another that Donald Trump won the election, or at least had as of a couple of weeks ago, certainly well after the election. And so I don't know. What's fringe in the what was marginal in the Republican Party 15 years ago, I think, is probably arguably its leadership now. But we'll see where you know, what percentage of Republicans are QAnon like in the House, just I would imagine in two or three cycles. However, Marjorie Taylor Greene was I don't know how to really articulate this, a Parkland and Newtown shooting denier.
False flag.
Yes, claiming that that these things were never happened or were manufactured or something to that effect. And she was appointed by Republican leadership to the Education Committee,
which is what outraged Nancy Pelosi.
Indeed. And I mean, it's one thing if you want to pretend like, oh, we have no control over what our voters do. They just sort of organically came to this own notion, which is not like we stoked these fires and they elected Marjorie Taylor Greene, and democracy calls for this. But I mean, if you're the leader of a party and you appoint someone who denied mass shootings in an elementary and in a high school to the Education Committee, I mean, gosh.
And the premise was that they were set up in order for the Democrats to take your guns away. This is a part of the trickle-down effect of Alex Jones and all of what he perpetuated and stoked.
Well, it turns out, and it makes sense, that it wasn't just the Parkland or the Newtown that she was skeptical of actually happening. Here's Marjorie Taylor Greene. All of 3 years ago, in her car, shooting a video suggesting that the Vegas shooting was also some form of false flag operation, of course, for the same ends.
Friends, I've got a question for you. How do you get avid gun owners and people that support the Second Amendment to give up their guns and go along with anti-gun legislation? How do you do that? Maybe you accomplish that by performing a mass shooting into a crowd that is very likely to be conservative, very likely to vote Republican, very likely to be Trump supporters, very likely to be pro-Second Amendment, and very likely to own guns. You make them scared, you make them victims, and you change their mindset, and then possibly you can pass anti-gun legislation. Is that what happened in Las Vegas? Is that why the country music festival was targeted? Because those would be the people, would be the ones that we would relate to? Are they trying to terrorize our mindset and change our minds on the Second Amendment? Is that what's going on here? I have a lot of questions about that. I don't believe Stephen Paddock was a lone wolf. I don't believe that he pulled this off all by himself. And I know most of you don't either. So I am really wondering if there's a bigger motive there, and does it have to do with the Second Amendment? Because what's the best way to control the people? You have to take away their guns. So that's just my question today. This is Marjorie Greene with American Truth Seekers. Mm-hmm.
Glad she signed off with her name there, so we could be absolutely clear.
Yes, I think we've identified who that woman is.
Yeah. By the way, were the children, the 7-year-olds, not at Parkland, but at Newtown, were they Trump supporters too? Was that the whole reason behind that false flag operation, where none of those children were actually murdered?
I guess you got to mix it up a little bit. You got to mix it up according to her. But she's just asking questions. Just asking questions. Here she is in 2019, a little bit more, not so much inquisitive, just a little bit more definitive in her perception of what's going on. And now, you know, we hear these things, Congress people are overblown. They're trying to pretend like they're victims because they're supposedly worried about people in Congress. You know, I'd be a little bit concerned about this, too, if I was working alongside this woman in the same locale. Here she is from February 2019 in Washington, D.C. This is a Facebook video. Incidentally, she's been oddly getting rid of all of her social media posts. That's odd.
Shocking.
Here it is.
Yeah.
Clip number 9.
She's a traitor to our country. She's guilty of treason. She took it.
I'm sorry. She is referring to Nancy Pelosi here as she's at a rally. And so, I mean, just think about this wording and if you'd be psyched to be working alongside a person who said this, who also, you know, has a long history. This isn't just empty rhetoric. There's a lot of insanity to back this up, as far as I'm concerned. But all right, start from the beginning.
She's a traitor to our country. She's guilty of treason. She took an oath to protect American citizens and uphold our laws. And she gives aid and comfort to our enemies who illegally invade our land. That's what treason is.
Exactly.
And by our law, representatives and senators can be kicked out and no longer serve in our government.
Yeah.
And it's a crime punishable by death is what treason is.
Yeah.
Nancy Pelosi is guilty of treason, and we want her out of our government. She's held her seat of power for 32 years. She's 78 years old. She is dying in Congress. We are fed up with these corrupt politicians that hang on to their power just to make themselves rich.
I mean, look, she says the punishment for treason is execution, and Nancy Pelosi is guilty of treason. And I mean, I frankly, with all due respect, Emma, if I saw a video of you saying this about me 2 years ago, that I was guilty of something that you thought was worthy of execution, I'd be a little uncomfortable about working in the same office as you.
I think that's unfair. No, but I mean, this woman is beyond out there, obviously. And she is the direct result of all of this online misinformation that culminated in the insurrection, that culminated in people voting for someone like this. That makes sense to them based on the Facebook videos they've seen, based on the misinformation they've heard on Alex Jones channels and other ones that are still on platforms like YouTube and things like that. So, I mean, it just got a little bit more real when voters actually responded to this kind of misinformation, this dangerous conspiracy rhetoric, and then elected someone who represented their views, how they felt about things. Like, there is no denying it. She is somebody who pretends like these hundreds of people who were slaughtered in mass shootings, like it didn't happen. I mean, she's not, it's the same thing like you say when like how Rush Limbaugh trained his audience to if Trump, you know, gives a wink and a nod to white supremacists, but he'll still condemn it. Oh, he has to come out and say that, right?
Right.
He has to. It's the same thing with her. But, like, she's still saying these things publicly. Imagine how she feels privately. I bet privately she's assured that they were false flags.
And the issue ultimately is not that there are individuals out there who hold nutso beliefs. The issue ultimately is that you have an entire party apparatus that refused at every juncture to not just shut down her candidacy. And obviously, you know, I think it would be undemocratic for them to come in and use extra democratic means, but to simply come out and say, this is nuts. They have cultivated a constituency, and I'm talking about the entire Republican Party, that embraces this type of belief system. Maybe it's not directly they create these false flags things to take our guns, but they hammer home for so many years that the Democrats, that Barack Obama, were out to take their guns under by any means necessary. Well, this just follows, and they never step in. They haven't. They exploit this. Kevin McCarthy right now is down in Mar-a-Lago, kissing the ring of the former president, soon to be, or certainly a twice impeached president, as a way of saying, like, you know, we are yours. Tell us what to do. And
also asking him for his help in the 2022 race to take back the Senate. I mean, to take back the House, excuse me. And we didn't even, like, get to these other videos of her. I mean, we talked about it the other day, of her following David Hogg, one of the survivors of the Parkland shooting, for 2 minutes and harassing him on the street. I mean, there are, of her belief that, her anti-Semitic belief that a space cannon started the California wildfires.
Well, to be fair, that was a space laser.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, yeah, I got my facts
financed
wrong.
By the Rothschilds.
Yeah, yeah. It's kind of the same anti-Semitism that you were hearing about the globalists from Alex Jones. She is the Alex Jones congresswoman, and this is legitimized in the Republican Party.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to be talking to Alex Perrine from the New Republic about everything that's going on, not only with the impeachment, but also with the COVID relief, and how those two are in many ways intertwined. We'll be right back after this.